you're not, welcome back. Thanks for coming back and sitting for some violin music today. My name is Kimberly Hope, as you can see on the sign there. And I come to Pono Kai as often as I can just to play for the guests as you're checking in each Saturday. And I live in Kapa'a area, so it's a perfect place to come on a weekend and just enjoy connecting with you all. So yeah, thanks for enjoying the music and some free snacks and drinks as well. Marilyn was nice enough to think of that idea, so hope you enjoy the festivities today. That song, the first song that I just played was called Rise Up, and it's one of my original songs. It's on my album, and I just tried to come up with my own style of instrumental violin music, and wanted to just start off with that one just to kind of lift the mood, because it's just an uplifting sort of song. I try to write music that has a positive, some sort of positive message to it. So I hope you guys enjoyed that one. And yeah, I just love playing music that can help people and heal and just make people happy. So I hope whatever I play today, you guys enjoy. Feel free to shout out like artists, bands, types of music that you really like. I enjoy all kinds. Actually just started getting into country music more, surprisingly. All these years I never really got into it, but maybe I'll share a couple country ones if there's people that enjoy that. But I like to do country, pop, rock, fiddle, soundtrack. Ooh, Taylor Swift, yes, I do like her. What songs do I know by her? I haven't played this one in a while, but I'm pretty sure you'll recognize it. I'll see if I can remember it.
I haven't done it in years.
Did you practice? I don't know.
His new girlfriend. first, she's like, oh my god. But I'm just gonna shake it to the fellas up in there with a hella good hair. But you come on over, baby, we can shake, shake, shake.
And your friend Daphne sang it.
Oh yeah, and the person that was saying the little rap in the middle, that was my friend. Her name's Daphne, and she's a singer here on Kauai. And she was nice enough to just record that little part for me in the middle, which is kind of fun. But yeah, here's Landslide by Fleetwood Mac. This is a really nice one.
Hope you practice it.
Thank you.
like your taste in music there. That was beautiful seeing some of you guys sing along. Yeah, feel free to sing along, dance along if you know the words to any of the songs. I like to play stuff that people hopefully recognize, you know. And it's cool because the violin, to me, the violin is one of the closest instruments to a human voice because you can, it's kind of got a similar range as far as the lower end of it. I mean, obviously people can't sing really the high notes on the violin, but you can do the technique called vibrato, right? Where it's that shaky, shaky quality that you can add to the tone, and that's kind of what we do when we sing. So I like to do songs that, you know, you can sing along to as well, because the violin's kind of like a voice. But yeah, how about, feel free to
speechless.
Do any
speechless.
Other requests. Oh, Mom has a request here. Oh, you got one? Oh, he was just waving. Mom said, do Speechless. Do you guys know Speechless by Dan and Shay? They're a, yeah, they're a country duo, kind of like pop country. Really amazing singer and great music. So I just learned this one, so hope you guys... Yeah, that's right. Dan and Shay are coaches on The Voice this season. They're brand new, and I've been watching. Yeah, it's pretty cool to have them on there. They got them and Reba. Reba McEntire, so we got two country ones.
Thank you.
guys. I'm glad you stopped by and listened to a random violin here in the Pono Kai. But yeah, it was Speechless. Check out Dan and Shay. Really good country duo there. And maybe I should do one that Grandma might like.
How about Rod Stewart?
That would be kind of cool. Oh, he was thinking that too. That's funny. Hey, Rod Stewart. Did I learn one by him?
You gotta practice that one. I mean, you gotta learn that one, though. Forever young. Yeah, you don't.
Bob Dylan?
Bob Dylan, oh. You have...
Dylan,
how about Beatles? She knows Beatles. In My Life? Mr. Randy wanted the Eleanor Rigby too.
Here's my favorite band, the Beatles.
Oh, wait, you got to stay for you.
Thank you.
recognize that one? Fly me to the moon. Grandma always says that. Fly me to the moon.
Alice.
Yeah, Frank Sinatra, man. Also a really amazing voice. My Way, I haven't learned that one yet. I gotta learn that one. It's like his most famous, his most famous songs. Yeah, that's on my list. Dust in the Wind, yes, I know that one. Perfect for violin as well. Great suggestion, Joe. Video on YouTube of that one. I knew you knew I did that song. Yeah, he told me right before I started playing, I've been watching you on YouTube and stuff. So that's awesome. Thank you so much for the support. And yeah, feel free to grab a card. I have a different social media. And I also teach violin and piano lessons at my home and online. So if you know of anyone that's interested in learning, shoot them my way. But I just really, maybe I'll play, speaking of like soothing, calming songs, maybe I'll play one of my originals that's
hopefully it's soothing for you guys as well. I did this one a couple weeks ago, but this one's called One and Only, and it's only violin and piano, and I wrote it just kind of around the idea of me ending up as the only grandchild on my grandma's side of the family. Even though she had four kids, they never had their own kids, so yeah, just somehow I ended up being the only grandchild, so it's just kind of a song that
only child,
captures my...
Only child, grandchild.
Yeah, only child, grandchild, all that through the generations on this side of the family, at least. But my dad's side has a bunch of cousins. But yeah, my auntie was like, you should write a song about being that and just being, well, grateful for, you know, being so close with my family and just having their support. So this one's for everyone in my family that's been very supportive of my dreams of playing music throughout the years. Shout out my grandma and my mom, and usually dad's here too, but he's kind of feeling under the weather today and catching up with things. But I just shout out my support and my momager and my grandma that always tags me. I'm so grateful she can still do that. She's 85 already and she's still going, so I wanted to, it made me think of just giving a little bit more backstory on, like, yeah, it took me many years to finish an album and come up with my own style, but where it all started was classical music. I was classically trained. I started playing when I was 10 years old, and my elementary school orchestra was just asking fifth grade students if they want to join orchestra, either play violin, viola, or cello. And I was like, oh, I kind of wanted to just sign up and try out violin. And I went home, asked my parents, and they were like, really? You want to do violin? That's kind of surprising because, I don't know, I never really showed much interest in music before, and none of my other family members were string players or anything, but okay, let's try and see if you like it. And thankfully, I picked it up and couldn't put it down, and I've been playing ever since and just fell in love with it. And yeah, started off with just classical music and orchestra, private lessons. That was in the mainland. I used to live in Missouri, near St. Louis area. And yeah, when we moved here in 2008, I was lucky enough to find some other violin teachers that I could continue learning from. So this is kind of an homage to the teachers that I've had throughout the years. And I wanted to play one of my favorite pieces by Mozart. I haven't done this one in a while, so we'll see how it goes.
Thank you.
back then. Yeah, I've always liked the Ina Kleina Nacht music, a little night music, and that's the first movement. But just very thankful for my classical training, but yeah, throughout the years I just started branching out and playing other genres and just love trying out all kinds of stuff. So I was thinking, ooh, I should play something for Donna. Donna's been a...
Everything you play is wonderful.
No, but I always love...
Play one more of your originals.
Oh, yeah. Do you have a particular one? Or?
No, just pick one.
Yeah, I was trying to think which ones I've not done in a while. Donna's been a supporter ever since many, many years ago already, right? She would watch me at the Kapa'a Art Walks, and then I started playing here, and yeah, she comes pretty much every time, and just thanks for always being there, Donna. Just great to connect with people through the music. So how about I try...
True Colors.
Oh, yeah. Did you know I play that one? Were you here last time? Yeah, I did play that one last time, I think. Yeah, for sure, I'll do that one. I wanted to do that one again. But let me try one more original for Donna here. Here's one that I haven't played yet, so hopefully... Well, I haven't played it here yet, I don't think. It's called Just Believe.
Thank you.
a much even greater audience than, well, I played at the Art Walk last Saturday, and I guess it was because of the weather. It was so cold and windy, and cold on Kauai's scale here, but I know you guys are all coming from colder places, I'm sure, but it was cold for Kauai, and yeah, it was a rough night, but it's nice to be here and just
under
in this intimate setting. It's warmer and more cozy with you guys, but yeah, let's try True Colors, Cindy Lauper.
What was I made for? Somebody wants what was I made for?
Yeah, I've always wanted to wear that one, and I finally did it. Did any of you guys ever watch that show, Glee, when it was out? It was popular a while ago, but Yeah, I kind of, in high school, I watched that show, and it had a bunch of singers on it that would sing different, you know, songs through different pop eras, and that was one of them that I really thought sounded nice, so glad I was able to finally learn that one. Thanks for the request, too, Joe. I got another request here on YouTube that my mom's streaming on my phone, and they wanted me to play that song from the Barbie movie that came out last mm-hmm. year that was sung by Ken's song. I don't know, yeah, not that one, but it's the one that Billie Eilish sings.
Oh yeah.
What Was
good.
I Made
that's
For?
Good, yeah.
Yeah, that's a really nice one too, so I'll try that for all the Barbies and Kens out there. It was funny, last week or 2 weeks ago when I was here, there was a guy that named Ken in the audience, so I dedicated it to him.
Hope you practice it.
Dynamics in that one. Oh, do you guys know what dynamics are? Sorry. That's a musical thing. It's like basically how loud and soft and all the different
volume levels throughout the song. And I just love how, like, yeah, you can get really soft and intimate. We call that in music, the word for that is piano. I don't know why it's spelled the same way as, like, the instrument piano. But when we say play piano, that means play really soft. And then when we say play forte, that means play loud. So, yeah, I love how it has all those different dynamics there. Makes it more emotional. But I just thought of another song from a movie. I want to see if anyone can actually has ever seen this movie. It's not, I don't know if it was popular or what, but it came out a long time ago now. Probably when did it come out?
I don't know what movie you're talking about.
The one that I haven't played yet.
I don't know. Is it gonna be weird? What movie?
It came out in like either the 90s or early 2000s, I think now. But yeah, here's a song from that movie, and we'll see if anyone recognizes it. I just wanted to learn it because it sounds kind of like the style of the Beatles, sort of. Has anyone seen that movie? Yes. Yes, I love that movie. I grew up watching it. I mean, my parents and I would always watch it. If you haven't seen it yet, it's kind of a movie like spoofing or like making a band that was supposed to be kind of like the Beatles, right? And how they became famous really fast with a hit like that. And Tom Hanks is one of the actors in it, and I think he directed. Yeah, he's the manager, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, good, you guys have seen it. I was just wondering if I was the only one that's seen that movie before. Because it's, you know, not like a blockbuster or anything, but yeah, just wanted to try it out, something different. But, yeah. Oh, it's
5:30. Just play some more.
What Keep should playing. I do for the last couple songs? Oh, do you guys like Hallelujah? I haven't played that one in a while. Yeah, I figured I might as well finish with something like that.
They have a good seat there,
yeah.
But luckily no rain. This is Marilyn's favorite song too. Marilyn.
Coming back again next Saturday, so we're still around. Feel free to stop by, and I'm trying to, if I don't have other gigs, I just try to come here as often as I can. So thanks Marilyn and all the staff and workers here that allow me to play and set up all the chairs for everyone. So Yeah, enjoy your stay here on Kauai. If it's your first time or your 50th time, and I hope you have an awesome stay and stay dry and not too cold, hopefully. It's pretty hot today, actually. But feel free if you want to check out business cards. I got CDs here, and $15 just for a CD, and I'd love to sign it for you and say hi and meet you guys if you want to chat a little bit here after I finish up. But aloha and mahalo. Thank you very much for being here today. Have a good week, rest of the weekend. Oh, and bye everyone on YouTube.
Thanks, guys. Maybe next time she'll play your song, Mood of Music wanted you to play Titanic and Sound of Silence, Song of Silence. Bye, guys. Yeah, there's a lot of... Yeah, I want Christmas.